All right, happy Monday to you guys here. This shop is all cleared out. We got some space, and look at this. This guy is out here. He's got some major ambition today. Hey, George, you know what today is?
Today is the day.
Look at this guy. He's got this thing all torn apart while we were pushing cars out.
He already got the exhaust manifold on there. And
just a couple, you know.
Do what you could. Things. I saw you out here with the Sawzall just a minute ago. What were you cutting up?
Cut the exhaust off, man.
Oh, you're committed now.
Oh, fully committed, yeah.
All right.
We're ready to win it now. I'm just going to sleep up there. Nice and warm.
Hell no, we're going to get this thing up and running, man. Ain't going to be that bad. As we start to tear this thing apart, it just occurred to me that there is something that I wanted to touch on here, and I'm about to talk nerdy to you. So anytime you guys are boosting something, I wanted you to know this. The PCV system has to be rerouted, okay? So this is the clean side coming in. Basically, this would be the clean side going in right there because this is the origin of vacuum. What that means is that all of the sucking of the PCV vapors starts here. So this is going to go into that valve cover. The valve cover is attached through the crankcase on this side. So clean side is seen and calculated by the mass airflow, which is down here. What does that mean for boost? That means that we completely have to revamp this. It has to be redesigned. Both of these need to either vent to atmosphere or go to the suction side. So when we have the turbo sitting here, we could have both of those PCV vents running to the front side of the turbo. What we don't want is we don't want boost going in either this side or that side and boosting the bottom end. That could be a really big problem. Plus, it's also a boost leak. So that's a big no-no. We'll show you how to get that all straightened away. But if we recirculate it at the front side of the turbo, that should be the cleanest, best overall solution. George, I'm marveling at that beautiful ported throttle body that you have there, buddy.
Yeah, that was one of my first ones. That's why we got JB Weld up there.
Oh, I forgot about that. I didn't realize that was one of the first ones. So that one is pretty aggressively ported, let's just say.
Got a little hole in her.
And so what we're doing here is we got a stock exhaust manifold. Now, George, I've seen a bunch of times with a header, like a big long tube header on something like this, the spooling time is garbage. So we gotta put this back to stock. This kit was designed for a stock exhaust manifold. Here we have the connection pipe right up there. And basically, if we have less volume to fill right there, this thing's gonna go spool pretty darn fast. So
we need that bottom end torque.
Yeah, yeah. Now, we kind of realized, hey, look, you are also on a TR6 spark plug right there. So we wanna go to, well, a colder plug, because we're gonna be making some more heat, right?
Exactly.
All right, so we're running a BR7 EF plug. That's pretty much anything we're gonna run on a forced induction application. We really wanna stay away from spark knock. Say, for example, guys with CTSVs and a lot of other things like ZL1s, they wanna run an Iridium TR6. And quite honestly, a BR7 EF, we can probably run about 2 degrees more spark advance. And sometimes that can be as much as 30 horsepower. Sometimes it's slim to nothing, you know, but we want our safety margin. So we're running that colder plug, and hopefully, George, we might be able to throw an extra pound of boost with those colder plugs.
All right. We'll take baby steps though, you know.
All right, we're getting there. We got our PCV system plugged off right there. So once we have our turbo mounted and our induction pipe plumbed, we'll go ahead and run both of the valve covers venting to right to the air filter or to the induction inlet right there.
Well, we might have to extend our mass airflow because it's gonna be coming out of the charge pipe all the way over here. It used to be all the way over here. Now it's gonna be all the way over here. We're gonna have to do something about this situation.
Yeah. Now, George, I saw you're pulling off the map sensor.
So yeah, we're gonna put one of those big boys in there.
So we're taking off. That guy only goes to 1.25 bar, so that would really only get us about maybe 4 pounds of boost-ish. And we're gonna go to the 3 bar. So basically, as we're going down the road, it is very, very important to see, well, what kind of load. Like in first gear, we might get 7 pounds of boost, and then second, we might get 9, and then third gear, we might get 11, but we just wanna be able to stay on top of that.
So, yeah, because this baby does all kinds of driving.
Mm-hmm.
Never know, Mustang might pull up beside me, I might just floor it, and we need to know how much boost she's making.
Rather than cutting and splicing harnesses, sometimes it's easier to run your way back into the harness and reroute the wire after you get back further in the harness.
I think that's like a super common problem. People are just like, how are we going to do this? And I'm like, dude, you can just disconnect a couple things. And
it's never good to have splice joints either, so if you can just do something like this, it works a lot better.
But what that keeps us from having to do is now our mass airflow should be able to reach all the way over. And we got plenty of room now.
Oh, so. Like Indiana Jones.
Yeah.
So we'll go behind the motor and keep it, make it nice and clean. And then that's less stuff to melt too.
Buddy, I know you've been wanting to see what this thing looks like up in there.
Oh, yes.
All that cutting. So once we cut out the bottom there, this actually looks pretty good. So we got to be able to build a bracket.
Fits in there nicely. Wow.
So we got to be able to build a bracket from something from like maybe here to here. But the top side, we had brackets on my Tahoe there. We're going to have to figure out something with that. But this is kind of where we want this thing to reside. Should be pretty nice, man.
Dude, it fits perfect in there.
Man, that front bumper cutout looked so good. Put this intercooler up really close to the front, and we're gonna actually shroud the bottom as well so none of that cold air escapes, funneling it all through the heat exchanger right there. That thing's gonna be really effective.
So that's George's crossover pipe there. We got that all squared away. We had to pretty much chop up what we had and almost start from the beginning.
Now the interesting thing that we didn't say here was that this was for a 4L60E car. So we noticed a couple things were ever so slightly different in fitment. This is a 6L80. We had some touching issues right there in the bell housing. So
yeah, it was also hitting the lines here too.
Ah, okay.
We had this piece of chrome ollie laying outside actually. And George, he was starting to make up some tabs. And I said, hey, I think we got a piece that would work really well for this. So cut it down a little bit. So what we're going to do is we'll just make a couple tabs here. So we can mount it to the frame rail here and make a couple tabs coming up forward, and it'll support that whole intercooler. No problem. Looks really good, man.
Yeah, that's going to look really nice.
I'll be slick when it's done.
Turbo's going to mount right up in here, and that drain should snake through and come in right there. If you guys are ever tackling something like that, I would definitely check out the Motion Raceworks ones. They have multiple different scenarios of how they set theirs up. All right, with what Ben's fitting up right there, right about where his hand is where the downpipe's gonna have to pass through, so that's a very delicate area. And as we can see, it goes from about a 3-inch to a 4-inch, but those are definitely some ugly, ugly welds. That is pretty early on, had a big gap to fill. I really don't have any excuses. All right, Georgie, now why are you doing that?
Well, we got our intercooler down at the bottom of the truck, and this here is gonna be our shroud. So we can force all that air through there, keep that in my ATs nice and cool.
So we're making
my funny bone. I'm keeping my composure, but it really hurts.
You did really good.
And it's not funny.
Make sure the heat exchanger is as efficient as possible.
As possible.
Ben had mocked this up. We got a nice little bracket drilled through those guys right there. We pretty much got our intercooler where we want to go. Now after this, we're going to be able to tackle all of our piping going to the turbo and from the intercooler right there. So all the air that would have been going through the bottom, which is a substantial amount right there, are funneling into the intercooler. George, that shield that you put in there looks awesome. Definitely going to direct all the airflow to the intercooler. Now guys, we have a little bit of a setback.
Yeah, little tiny one.
All right, so we got a little setback here, George.
So our timing chain cover, it's not gonna work. So this truck has variable valve timing, VVT. A lot of you truck guys get a VVT cam. That's this little solenoid up here. Okay, our old one off of Jeremy's 07 Tahoe did not have VVT. So we're gonna put our thing, we were gonna put our fitting on this pan. But since we have a dash 10 rather than a dash 8 feet, it's a lot bigger and it's going to interfere with our AC belt. And down here in Florida, the Sunshine State, we need some AC, man.
So wait. You are Mr. No AC.
Well, I'm a daily. And the race truck, I'll yank it right out of there. If it gets too late, We'll be yanking AC out of this thing, all right?
We had another mild setback. Yeah.
You know, the little stuff kind of does back you up, especially when you got to re-engineer something now. This is our turbo oil supply line.
Yes, sir. This is like an LS1 style walk-off plate, you know, redirects the oil in and out right here. But this truck has an oil cooler on it. Don't know why I didn't think about that ahead of time.
So instead of that piece right there, we had to kind of use a sandwich. Now, is that an ICT billet? Is that ICT billet piece right there?
Oh, nice.
For an LT.
The size and stuff, we had to add new bolt holes to it, but hey, it already has little fittings in there. Bingo, bango, bondo.
It's going to do the job. Because I got the exact same setup as he does, except mine's assembled. And he can slide right under the front of my truck and get right to this.
All right, so what we're looking at is we're trying to make sure that we can have this run of the oil return going to the front cover and make sure it's going to fit. Now, George's is all taken apart. So we got Liza's truck, a working example.
And what's going to come out here, a braided line? Yeah, I mean, that's going to work. You just need to get the right angle on there, you know?
Well, when we started this video, it was Monday, so happy Tuesday to you right now.
Happy Tuesday! My second favorite day of the week after Monday. The day that I get my turbo. Today's the day, we come saying. Today and tomorrow.
Well, it's still a 24-hour period. We have had a number of different setbacks, and we have overcome most of them. We're still working on a couple of others. We've got all of our piping for our cold side done. We've got to mount the turbo here yet in just a moment. We've tried to keep the couplers to a minimum so that we wouldn't have to be fighting any blowing off or anything like that. We have a couple different areas where we do have to have certain couplers. We're going to have one coming straight off the turbo right here, but we could not make this piece out of one piece. So,
Really a lot of setbacks. We just changed a lot of stuff, you know?
So yes, we started with a turbo kit, but it would have been nice if things fit perfectly. We're making some really good improvements on what's already there. So George has been fighting this timing cover deal with the drain for the turbos, and we have had this off and on, I don't know how many times, but this should be the right placement so that we should be able to have our drain coming down here and still be able to clear the balancer.
All right, it's gonna be close, so.
Go right off there.
George, you are living dangerously, brother.
Yeah, it's close, man. That's what you call living on the edge.
Close. It's on the AC bracket.
Well, buddy. Yeah. Extra close to that. I was saying close to the other part. Thanks for pointing that out in front of everybody. I told you I was going to run a little piece of sandpaper through there, make an air gap. Do a little...
I don't know if you can get sandpaper through there, bud.
Yeah. Oh, man, that's going to be so perfect.
Looks really good. I like the positioning and all that.
Dipstick goes colors.
Yeah. Yeah, we still got to fit that guy in there, and we got one more plug wire to go.
Hopefully that zip tie probably going to melt, huh?
It may. We're going to have the blanket in between there, though.
Heat shield on there.
We're getting there. Let's go see what we got from the bottom side. Oh, we can put our water pump on, though, right, Coop?
Sure can.
Little stuff like this is what's devouring time. So that guy right there, because we're running a dash 10, we thought about being able to grind a little bit on our T4, but it seemed like a better idea to kind of grind on that right there.
I see air between the two.
That is good. That's great. So we're ready to roll with this guy, and that can go right in and right there. Oh,
careful, man. You're giving me anxiety. I've only got one of these. I'm trying to get that V-band on there. Looks like it's a tough one.
Move it around a little bit.
Which way?
Go back down. Where you had it. Alright, hold on.
It's only 1 o'clock.
I think that's on.
It's on?
It's on.
Yeah!
Alright, I don't know if you guys can really see that, but that is touching there, and we've got probably, I'd say, a quarter inch at most right there.
Contact!
Living dangerously. Alright, we got our balancer back on, we got our little stretchy belt for the AC. So we got our hand-me-down blow off valve, but I know you're gonna be, oh, we gotta route that. We haven't done that yet. So we gotta have a line for that. I love this mount.
Yeah, it's so heavy duty, and we don't even have any top bolts in it yet, but like, it literally like.
This like churched up the whole thing a whole lot, man.
Churched it on up.
Oh, we have one other special thing here, right here. We totally forgot to mention this earlier. We have a Leroy remnant. This is a part that was on the Leroy build from the beginning, the OG stuff. from, geez, man, this has got to be like 3.5-4 years ago. This was the inlet for when Leroy went nines on the LSA supercharger.
Perfect.
It does fit pretty good. I mean, it needs a little tweakage, but dude, really, really nice. I love recycling old parts.
Yeah.
Especially ones with history right there.
Even recycled that self-tapper. Found it on the floor. Pulled it out of a tire.
Is it finally sinking in?
Dude, it's really finally sinking. I can't wait to drive. Yeah, I can't wait.
All right, Ben. We appreciate your efforts despite you feeling so junky.
Oh, it's all good, man.
George, you had sold your other wastegate and thus presenting the problem.
Yeah,
we had
a customer with a turbo truck wastegate. What happened? It jammed up or something, right? Chinese one?
Yeah, I think
no
something.
No offense. I'm just saying. And, well, sure enough, I had to sell them mine. Well, I didn't have to. You kind of, like, didn't want me to. But, you know, what are you going to do? Guy needs help. Really put me in a pickle come time I needed a wastegate, but whatever.
You get a brand new one out of the deal.
Yeah.
It's coming together, buddy. Coming together. Come on, come on.
Yeah.
All right, Georgie, you're minutes away. All right, so guys, we've been having a whole bunch of problems with the fuel injectors. We're so close to firing this thing up, and it's just about 3:48 a.m. We're all whooped. Did a great job. It's been a long day. I mean, you've been messing around with this now, what is it, about 18 hours?
Yeah, something like that.
Almost 4 in the morning. Looking real good though, man. Definitely came through with all sorts of different problems and all that stuff and solutions. Got Leroy's cold air intake on there. Got that all zip tied. That'll last till tomorrow until we mount that.
Got our PCM relocated.
Dude, the that
oh dang, the blow-off valve never hooked that
no,
up.
No, I did. I hooked it up.
Oh, okay.
Yep, it is all hooked up, man. We'll get some psh going on the street. Here. Yeah. Let's go rip it, man.
Let's go rip it, man. Tune up in there and everything.
Yeah, we're just gonna check out like a.
She's blowing.
Oh, a little like lean that. Right there. Yeah. Well, that's as we're transitioning into boost, so yeah, we're gonna need some more fuel there real quick.
A little lean, huh? She said.
Good.
That didn't take long.
Yep, no problem.
That means you know she's making some steam.
Alright, so let's fix that. We'll be right back at you momentarily. Alright, so this thing's making boost a lot quicker, a lot easier than we thought. So let's try and see if we can get this thing to get some enrichment here now. Dude, it smells like definitely got some fuel, so we gotta... Oh, dude, the bluff house sounds really good.
Yeah! We're hitting everybody with that thing.
All right, so we got a drivable. Tomorrow, we dyno.
Sounds that you want?
Yep. Can't wait till it's fully tuned though. It's gonna be a whole different animal. Alright, let's see first gear what she has. A little bit, half model or so.
Okay, starting to feel real good right at the end there.
Yeah, that was probably too much, honestly, but pretty good. What are you gonna do? Yeah, it does start to feel good, man. I got a turn ski on here, man.
Alright, self-control until this thing gets tuned.
Keep it calm. That's definitely the most throttle I've given her so far.
I'm gonna assume this is how your whole hour drive home last night and this morning was.
All the way. Every time I pull up next to somebody, I like.
All right, from all of us at Fasterproms, we have given it our all today. I mean, there is no doubt about it.
None left.
Yeah, there is nothing.
Yesterday, today.
Yeah, yesterday, Anthony.
Everybody looks like they're, you know, well.
Everybody looks like it's 5 o'clock in the morning.
That's because, probably because it is.
Hey, but it was a great day, though. Good job, buddy.
Hey.
Thanks for the help.
Laz seriously gave all of it.
Why is your hand all wet? Whatever.
Don't ask these questions. Seriously, the birds are seriously starting to chirp and stuff outside here, so we're all gonna go home and get some sleep. So I'm really excited for you. He loves all the turbo noises and all the whistles and blow-offs.
Sounds good, man.
Oh goodness.
Oh, good thing I got a long drive home every time I go.
All right, guys, so one last thing that we're going to end this note on here, just some good music that we all listened to pretty much while we were assembling and doing a bunch of stuff here, and Sublime, 40 Ounces of Freedom, whole album, man. It's good stuff. Hope you guys enjoy. God bless you. We'll see you next episode where Georgie's going to make some power.
Yeah, buddy.
Bad dream.